This is our main data set. We have the user ID, the movie ID, and the rating, followed by the genres as well. What I'm going to do is segregate all of them into specific columns. And there we go, we get the recommendation for user one with the top five movies. First, we want to start off with installing the main library that we'll be using in this video, and it's called scikit-surprise. So just type in pip install scikit_surprise, that, and run this code cell. Now this is going to take a while to run, but then before that is completed, let me just type in all of the things that I will require from scikit-surprise. First, let's just import, the abbreviation is just surprise. From surprise, we want to import dataset followed by reader, and then we will also have to import the main model that we will be using in the video. You just have to type in from surprise.predictionAlgorithm.matrixFactorization, like that. We want to import the SVD model, which stands for singular value decomposition, and then we also want to import the accuracy metric from surprise to evaluate how the model is performing. From surprise, import accuracy, like that. And then I'm also going to import pandas, just to load in the data and pre-process it, SPD, like that. Now, after this is done, you want to run this code cell, all of these four modules we will need in this video. Now, after that is done, as for the dataset, what you have to do is, from the movie lens site, you want to install the ML latest small dataset. This will contain all of the movies and the ratings given by different users for those movies. And this is the data that we will give to our model to make predictions and recommendations. Make sure you install that, and it will come in the format of zip file. After you extract it, you will get five files like this. Just make sure to drag and drop the movies and the ratings CSV onto here, onto the Google Colab. And once that is done, you can just directly load the data by using the pd.read_csv function. So first, let me just call the ratings CSV, ratings DF, and then follow that up with the movies DF. Just use the pd.read_csv function, ratings CSV, have this to be movie CSV like this. Now, when we actually have a look at these two, let's just type in ratings.csv, ratings DF, I'm sorry. When you run this, you get to see the data itself, and you see there is four columns, user ID, movie ID, and then the rating given. Now, when you look at the movies DF, you will see that the same column exists over here, the movie ID, and then the title, followed by the genres. So what we want to do is merge these two datasets based upon the movie ID, and then we get the main dataset. So we do this by using the pd.merge function. Our main data frame will be pd.merge function. So this, you first want to mention the ratings data frame, and then follow that up with the movies data frame. But then this time, I'm not going to import all of it. So this, we want only two specific columns. One is the movie ID, and then I also want the genres, like that. And we want to group them by the movie ID. So you just have to type in on movie ID, like that, and then on the left-hand side. So now when we actually have a look at the data set, okay, over here, like that. Now when you run this is our main data set. After using the pd.merge function, we have the user ID, the movie ID, and then the rating given to that specific movie, followed by the genres as well. Now what I'm going to do is use the label encoder function to segregate all of them into specific columns, and if that movie comes under that specific genre, then it will be true. If it doesn't come, then that column will be false. So to do this, we will have to use the one-hot encoder, or we can also use the multi-label binarizer from scikit-learn. And also, I'm going to use the label encoder for movie ID and user ID, because the range that goes over here on the movie ID is not unique. It doesn't follow any straight pattern. It has some random value. So we have to import those two from sklearn.preprocessing, label encoder, and then multi-label binarizer, just like that. And this code cell once again. Now, after you imported that, what you have to do, you want to create three encoders. One is the user encoder, follow that up with movie encoder, and then we also have to have the genre encoder. Actually, rather than using the genre encoder, we can just directly use it onto our data frame. I'll show you how, but then first we need the user encoder and the movie encoder. And I'm going to call the multi-label binarizer as MLB. Just first, let's start over here, multi-label binarizer. This is the class that we imported. I'm just using the instance over here. And then for the other two, let's just use the label encoder, fill that up, put that over here as well. Now that we have created all of those, so let's just modify our data frame. Our main user ID will be, by using the user encoder function, .fittransform. I'm going to first mention df, and then provide in the user ID. Similarly, I'm just going to do this for the movie as well. Movie ID, like that. And then what you have to do is use the multi-label binarizer to actually get the genres segregated based upon their specific action. And you can just have those as specific column. This is basically known as one-hot encoding. So what we have to do is our main data frame will be df.join function. Then inside this, let's just use the pd.dataframe function. Inside this, you want to mention the mlb.fittransform. So df.pop, we don't need the genre column anymore. We only want the specific values inside those. Let's just clear this genre column itself by using the pop function, so df.pop. And inside this, you just mention the genres. This will return the genres column, and then we want to convert this to string and then split that up by using this symbol, because as we see over here, each and every genre is having a separation with this symbol, so we want to use it over here after that is done. Now we're using the multi-label binarizer, so all of the columns created, they also have to have a name. So those names will be mlb.classes. This is just the names of everything that was extracted from the main genres. And then we also want to have the index to be df index, just the index of the main data frame. So when you actually have a look at the data set now, let's just add in a code cell and then type in df. Actually, I forgot to run this. There you go, you see that we have this no genres list, which we want to delete. But before that, let's just have a look at the all of the new columns that was created, the action, adventure, and all of the different genres available. First, we want to delete this, just copy this, and then use the df.drop function. That is, columns will be, paste this like that, and type in place equal to true, then now type in df. There we go, we get all of the different genres of specific columns. And we have the rating, movie ID, and the user ID. Now, this is the perfect data set that we can provide to the model to make predictions. As far as this goes, we are going to use this surprise model, which is known as SVD, as I already told you. And this SVD will only take in a surprise converted object. So we have to convert the entire data set into a surprise object. And this is why we imported the reader initially. And we have to use the reader function to read the data frame. So the rating scale will be, we already have the ratings from 0.5 to 5. Now, this is used to read the entire data set and then identify the given ratings and rank accordingly. Now we want to get the data itself, and this will be done by using the dataset function, which again we imported from scikit-surprise. Right about here, we imported the reader and the dataset functions. Just type in load from df. This is a function to load the entire data set from the main df that we created. And over here, rather than passing in the entire data, I actually want to perform a train test split, because we want to evaluate how the model is performing. So what we can do is go ahead and import from sklearn. We want to import the train test split and then use this function down. First, let's just run this code cell. After we come over here, let's just have the train df come at the test here using the train test split function that we just imported, pass in the main data frame. And then our test size will be 20% of the main data. So just type in 0.2. Cut this, paste this over here. So when you run this code cell and look at the train df, we'll have 80% of the training data, which is actually what we want. You want to mention the train df that we just extracted from the main data frame. And then we would lead the user ID first, follow that up with the movie ID. And then I also want to have the rating. And then pass in the reader that we just created to read the data. And create our main train set, which should be provided to the model. This time we want to use the data.build full train set. Go train set. Our train set will be a new data set built from the surprise library. In fact, let's just run this and show you train set. You get a surprise train set object, which is what we have to provide to the model. And the way we do this is, actually, let's just create a new code cell over here. Again, our main model SVD will be the SVD instance that we imported there. We're just using those over here. And then type in model underscore SVD dot fit, pass in the train set. And then we also want to make predictions simultaneously. So let's just create the predictions variable. Predictions SVD will be model underscore SVD dot test function this time. And then inside this, you want to build a test set, which again can be done by using a specific function known as train set dot build anti test set. Now this function will create a similar test set based upon looking at the training set and look how the model is performing. And then we want to see the accuracy. We already imported this, so we're going to use the root mean square error. And inside this, just pass in the predictions underscore SVD. Now this will compare the original values as well as the predicted values from the prediction SVD. Actually, you don't have to put this in quotes. And then see how the root mean square error is performing. In fact, when you just run this, we are going to allow for our model to train. Okay, so we get the root mean squared error, which has the value of 0.47, which is actually considerable, which is nice for making recommendations. And in order to make the recommendations, it's kind of tricky. So what we have to do is first identify for which user we have to make the recommendation. And then for that user, we have to first know what movies did the user give ratings for. And we want to subtract that from the main movies dataset so that we can identify which movie can be recommended to the user selected. But then we also make sure that we don't recommend the same movie that they've already rated. So the way we do this is, actually, let's just create this as a function. Get, let's say, top end recommendations. So it is, first we want the user ID. Again, after we know that, we also want to know how much movies do we want to recommend. Let's just say, by default, we want to give 5 movies. Inside this, we first have to use the user movies, that is the movies that has already been rated by the given user, df of df user ID, which is equal to the provided user ID. Follow that up with the movies that they have already rated, movie ID, and then we want the unique values of those. What we have done here is we have extracted the record where the user ID is equal to the matching ones in the records. We get the unique movie ID of those so that we can subtract that from the main movie dataset. What we could do is all movies, first let's just create this. All movies will be df of movies, and that's about it. Let's just use the unique function just for safety, like that. So from this all movies, we want to subtract the movies that the user has already rated. And I'm just going to call this movies to predict, which will be list of, I'm going to create this as a set, all movies minus set of user movies, like that. And since that is done, we can now make predictions by the collaborative filtering model that we just created, user movie pass. And this will be the IDs from the movies to predict list. So what I have to do is I'm going to create a list comprehension. Again, you will understand this as I type it. User ID, follow that up with movie ID. This is going to be in the format of a specific matrix. And I want this to be three columns. For movie ID in movies to predict. I guess this is kind of understandable. What we're doing here is looping through all of the movie that we have to predict, and then storing that for that specific user, and then predicting the user rating for that specific movie. What this SVD model does is it will predict what rating will the user give for that specific movie ID, and then based upon that, we want to sort that from top and then give recommendations. So let's just call this prediction CF, type in model SVD. This is the model that we created, dot test, provide the user movie pass, like that. And now we have the predictions ready. As I told you, we will get all of the ratings for the movies that the users haven't rated. And based upon that, this is just the predicted ratings for all of the movies. And based upon that, we want to sort that from the top to get the perfect. And then we want to sort that from the top side, that is in descending order, so that we get the maximum predicted ratings for some movies. And then we can make recommendations based upon that. So let's just call this top n recommendations. This is the one that we're going to return. And I'm just going to use the sorted function directly. Inside this, use the prediction CF. And then we want to first mention the function that we want to use over this prediction CF. That is what the sorted function does. It takes in a sequential data, and then over that we have to mention the key, which is a function, and that function will be implemented on the prediction CF. So inside this key, I'm just going to type in lambda x, getting out those values one by one. You just have to type in x est. Right here, I just want to say that this model will give us the estimated rating of a user for a specific movie. It will provide us a rating number that the user might give to a specific movie, and that's what the model's job is to do. So here, this estimate function will give us that exact number that I just mentioned, and then we are using that to sort the entire predictions that we made, and then we want to have that in the reverse order, so I'm just going to mention the reverse equal to true over here. This is the estimation, and then we also have to type in reverse equal to true. We want to get the first n records after providing that in descending order. Now what we have to do is again get these movies one by one and print them in order. So what we can actually do is top n movies, let's just get the IDs directly. Top 10 movie IDs will be, use the int function and then get the index directly. Just type in pred IID. Again, use the list comprehension for pred in top n recommendations. So we're looping through the top n recommendations as a pred variable, and then we use the IID function, which is just basically the index or the ID that we have mentioned for that specific movie. And then we get that, and this will be in the format of the label encoded value. So we want to follow that up with inverse transforming it once again. So we just do that by top n movies. Let's just call that to be top n movies, like that. We just do that by using the movie encoder once again, dot inverse transform this time, and then pass in the top n movies that we got, like that. And then let's just return this top n movies, like that. Let's just run this. Now that that is done, it's time for us to make predictions. Let's say I mentioned the user ID to be 1. So I want the predictions for the first user, and then recommendations will be, use the user defined function that we just created, get top n recommendations, pass in the user ID like that. N is already by default set to 5, so we can just directly print that. And then rather than getting the index itself, this will just give the movie ID. We want the movie title name itself. So what we can do here is again create another variable, top n movie titles, use the movie data frame, it's called the movies data frame. Set this for the first again. Use the movies data frame where we just get the ID, movie ID, like that, dot is in function. just pass in the recommendations. This will give us all of the values where the movie ID matches the predicted movie ID that we got from the main function that we just created. And then inside this, you can just mention the title. Let's just have this to be list so that it would be easier for us to print. And then we can just type in formatted string. Top 5 recommendations for the user will be user ID. We can just mention that. Then create a for loop for I and title. Then use the enumerate function. Pass in the top n movies that we got from the main function. We'll follow that up with 1. Then print again. Just create a formatted string. Pass in 1. That is I. And then we get the title. Now, when you run this, actually, we don't need this. Oops, I have to put this as movie ID. Like that. Now you have to run this. Then run this. And there we go, we get the recommendation for user 1 with the top 5 movies. Let's just try that for another user, 221. And we get a different set of recommendations based upon the model's predictions. Again, if you want to actually see the ratings itself or how the model is rating the movies, you can just print that out as well. Here we have the top end recommendations. What we can do here is given a for loop for spread in recommendations. We have that in the list comprehension, but then I also want to print it and print in top end recommendations. Movie ID will be int of the predicted rating for a specific movie. The estimate function, once again, I told you earlier, dot estimate, then print that, print the predicted rating like that. So now just run this. Now when you run this, you not only get the recommendations, but you also get the predicted rating for that specific user. As we see, it goes from top to bottom. Whereas when you actually don't mention reverse is equal to true. Let's just try that on this and then run this. So these are the top 5 not recommended movies for user 221, and you see the predicted rating for that as well. Again, I hope you understood this estimate function. It just gives us the estimated rating for a specific movie using the model that we created.